How's it going, y'all? Welcome to Brick Foundation. And on today's episode, we're finally going to unbox the eBay Bidding War set from a few weeks ago. And also, as a little bonus, I have a few more sets that I've purchased on eBay that have finally come in. So let's not waste any more time. Let's go and take a look. Okay, so we're going to start off from where we left off on the teaser trailer. And we're just going to go ahead and pull it right out. Here it is. The LEGO Technic 8480 Space Shuttle from 1996. I really can't believe I'm having this right now. It's in my hands. Whew. What is it, 25 years since I've waited for this? Really doesn't seem real. One thing I'll never understand is why LEGO stopped making packaging like this. I mean, taking a look at the box, flipping open the flip cover, seeing the presentation of the box, all the pictures that are gonna be included, this is just so much better than what they have now. You get a lot more excited when you see this. One of the highlights that jumps out to me from the box in the front cover is gonna be this beautiful sparkle foil that they have that says fiber optic. This is very reminiscent of 90s baseball cards or basketball cards. I love this. Another artistic highlight that jumps out to me from the front of the box is if you look behind the space shuttle, you see a blue highlighted architectural silhouette of the LEGO Technic space shuttle itself. I love those little details, something that's really missing nowadays. Let's flip it over on the back. Now, something that I didn't even know that was included in this set was an alternate build, a submarine. This is very interesting. Now, I would never build it because I'm too obsessed with the space shuttle, but I'm definitely gonna check to see if there's any videos online to see if anybody's actually built the submarine. Let's open this thing up. Look at that, still sealed, guys, look at that. I can't believe it's lasted this long. Oh, and the sticker sheet. Here, this side is gonna be all your space shuttle stickers. And over here, your submarine. Looks really good condition for 1996. These are the cables that I'm worried about. These are probably just gonna break down and deteriorate into dust. Actually misses perforated plastic bags. These will be soon replaced with paper. Instruction booklet. No sticky pages, so that's a good sign for humidity. Look at that, just highlights all the features that are included. To show that you need a 1.5 volt battery. Let's take a look at the sorting tray that actually LEGO included with the set. Now, when this was first released in 1996, it retailed for $158 and included 1,368 pieces, even including all these little guys. Ah, here's some more of those cables. Whew, I will handle these with care. Definitely probably gonna have to replace these when I actually do the build sometime in the future. Let's see how many bags are included. One, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So 16 bags, a few pieces left out, loose. And the packaging, of course, is steel sealed that holds all the motors. One thing I want to say is please, LEGO, give us another sorting tray. Let's put some of the stuff back. Do I even remember where this stuff goes? Sticker sheet on top. Slides right back. Let's go ahead and put all this back. If I remember right, instruction booklet, then the sorting tray. Flip cover goes back. Slide that back in. And then flip cover. Now, if this video gets 2,000 likes, I will do a video and I will actually break this open and build it. Okay, well, now that this is done, let's move on to some of the other eBay sets that I purchased. So for this one, I really was too excited and I broke this one up already, but let me go ahead and show you what I purchased. Oh. Yes. Move that box out of the way. You already know I'm obsessed with the LEGO System Space Shuttle sets that were out in 95. Some of the sets I was able to purchase when I was a kid, some of the other ones I wasn't. These are some of the sets that I was not able to get when I was a child, and I'm really excited that I was able to find them. Still sealed, still brand new. This one, set number 6457, includes only one minifigure, and it's just going to be an astronaut with its rocket pack. I love the simplicity of this, love the colors, I love the chrome-plated helmet visor. I wish they still made those. I'm a fan of the way this looks versus the new astronaut sets. Please bring back the chrome-plated gold visor. The next one is the Spaceport Bonus Pack. Now this whole little package here was worth $12.97 as far as like the value pack, retailed for $10.99, so what, you saved a couple bucks. The Spaceport Bonus Pack, set number was 6469 and included three sets. And the bonus set you got was this one right here, a little launch command, which retailed for $2.99. So really, I guess it was only a $2 bonus. Now this bonus pack came out in 1999 and includes three minifigures. Two of them are astronauts and one of them appears to be a scientist. Or a rocket scientist, should I say. Flip it over on the back. It says, check out these cool new sets. 6454, Countdown Corner. 6455, Space Simulation. And 6456, Mission Control. Actually, no, I had the 6456 Mission Control. And I didn't really like that one as much as the 1995 sets that came out. And here, join the LEGO Club for free for a 2-year membership includes 12 new issues of LEGO Mania Magazine. Details inside, see product brochure, cool creations, building tips, contests, special offers, and more. I love this, so 90s, I love that. Okay, moving on. Now this set is still sealed, so I will open this up, you know, right in front of me. All right, here we go. Now this is picture perfect. This is exactly how you should package a set. Nice bubble wrap. Woo! Now that is pretty. This is gonna be another bonus pack. Now this one's gonna be worth a little bit more. Instead of being $12.97, this one is worth $25.97. So an increase of $13. Now one of the things that pops up to me is gonna be that SpongeBob font right here for the $25.97 value, now only $19.99. Who agrees with me on that one? 15 hours later. Now this bonus set, these three here, actually went along with my 1995 Space Shuttle set. Something I like about this bonus pack here is that they actually include set numbers on here. First one you get is the 6516, next one you get is 6614, and 6336. And this is all still brand new, sealed. Now in this bonus pack, you get four minifigures. First one you get is gonna be an astronaut and moonwalker. The minifigure you get in Launch Evac 1 is gonna be a minifigure in a hazmat suit. This one right here was my favorite growing up. I really, really wanted it. Wasn't able to get it. Next one, you get two minifigures. One of them is a pilot, and the other one appears to be some type of mechanic. I love the simplicity of the box art from back then. Another theme with these two bonus packs. Does LEGO even do bonus packs anymore? Let me know in the comments below. When's the last time you saw a bonus pack similar to these that LEGO has done in recent years? Now, the Moonwalker set retailed for $3 in 1995 and is currently going for around $15 to $20. Launch Evac retailed for $9 back in 95 and is currently going new sealed for around $53. Now, the Launch Response Unit retailed for $16.50 back in 95. Currently, right now, brand new sealed, $75. Now, I was able to get this set for a great price on eBay. I will include the store down in the description below. And you get the SpongeBob font for free. Now, unfortunately, we don't get any box art in the back of this packaging. It's just the plain cardboard for display purposes. But we at least get a hook. All right, guys, there you have it. The unboxing from LEGO eBay Bidding Wars and the bonus eBay sets that I was able to purchase as well. Now, leave me a comment down below. How many of y'all actually have these sets or had them back in 95? And which one is your favorite? All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, if you like this kind of content, like this video, share this video, and subscribe to this channel for all the latest LEGO news, and I'll see you guys later.